What I find interesting is it seems like you're kind of trying to downplay a lot of your accomplishments up until this moment, because like you're walking us through your story and there's no chance that you were that lucky that many times in a row where like just like the natural flow of, I don't know, the current you were in just kind of took you to success after success after success. I feel like you need to
Well, I think it's also just hard work too, because it's the willingness to be on and do things people aren't willing to do. Because a lot of girls like who use their body for money, you know, there's like a reason they do that, is because it seems like a shortcut, right? And there are a lot of girls who will spend time doing that. But in the streaming space also, there's not that many who are like super hard grinding and will just be on as long as it takes to get that efficiency out of their work. So a lot of them still want to enjoy their time. They want to like travel. They want to have free time. And that's nice. But I'm like paranoid, you know, I don't know how long it'll last.
You're very much goal driven towards having a sanctuary and like building up enough income.
Yeah. Passively. It's like, I still want to go and I want to de-stress on certain mornings, but like, I don't, you know, I'll go to the barn and I'll come back. Right. Mm-hmm. And then I'll work. It's not like I'm traveling everywhere.
So you think one of the main things that sets you apart from the competition is the work ethic?
Yeah, no, definitely. Cause it's like, you have to be online in order for the algorithm to go in your favor. Cause for Twitch, they reward time streamed, and nowadays like you can kind of piggyback if you get like an org like OTK or someone, or offline TV, they kind of like they feed off of each other because they're using the same fan group essentially. So mm-hmm. that fan group who is like a fan of the content also go to like every stream, and so your streams don't have to be long to get viewership or stuff because you're all just sharing one big audience essentially. But if you're kind of by yourself, you don't have that like feedback loop from like this character arc of like stories all intermingling, and you kind of just have to grind out the algorithm hours if you're a solo person.
What's your biggest insecurity?
I would say maybe my inherent entertaining level, because by myself it feels like it's hard to keep up with what currently people find entertaining, because they do find like drama entertaining, and it's hard to kind of farm that when you don't have like a content house or like other streamers that you're constantly collabing with to kind of feed that into.
So you think that you need to chase the trends in order to be entertaining? You think that you don't have that innate just like ability to be entertaining?
No, I don't think entertaining. So. And it also is harder too for women, because we aren't as seen as like relatable by the majority of Twitch audience, which is male. Mm-hmm. You know, people typically will watch if she's attractive, but they don't really watch because they feel like that they relate to her per se. Some of the females might, but that's not the majority of Twitch audience still. It's still mostly males. So it's kind of hard to feel like you're entertaining truly, because part of it is like, yeah, they are there for your appearance. You know, that's like the value that a lot of them found you through. And some will stay for your personality, but there's also some weird stigma behind like watching women still. It's like, she's not going to fuck any of you. You know, people say that in the chat at each other, being like, why do you guys watch and just donate and subscribe? She's not going to fuck you. Like, as if like that's the only reason why they would associate with women is to be able to fuck them. Mm-hmm. There's still very much like that, that dominating societal stigma, I guess.
Now, what do you feel like the reason is that they're there watching for such a long time?
I think some have just like formed a kind of community feeling, because they talk to each other in chat, right? And they'll like support the streamer, they enjoy the streamer's personality, they just feel it's kind of like a virtual hangout session, you know. It's kind of it's similar to why some people support guy streamers, but there's just less who feel like they can enjoy a female streamer if she's not fucking them, or if that fantasy isn't there that she might one day maybe. So some are just like very naysayers. It's like, why would you watch a female? She's not gonna sex you, because they don't see females as like friends or entertainers.
Right.
They see females as like an accessory. No. So
what do you think is the biggest threat to humanity?
Biggest threat to humanity. Oh god. I think ourselves destroying the planet. Not having
you
a planet.
You think it's the environmental
anymore.
Changes?
I think it's not really the environment changing. I think it's just humans like destroying ourselves, either like both the environment, but then also each other. I think we like the social media aspect encourages drama and conflict and disagreements, and you see people doing crazier and crazier things.
AI as well, which is human generated. Well,
AI is the least of my concern, to be honest. I think it's more of what people choose to do, because you see the news covering only negative things. Mm-hmm. People are more likely to go on crazy violent rampants if they feel like that's what will get them attention, because it's like the media, while making people aware of it, is also kind of glorifying like shootings and things like that. Right. They're only
some media outlets don't
more.
Release the names of the people yeah. that do that, which I think is kind of nice.
Yeah, that's true. But I don't know if that really helps as much if you're already insane.
Yeah.
You're just like, I want people to talk yeah. about me, whether.
I think that yeah. was actually a really yeah. good answer. Yeah.
Yeah, I agree with that completely.
Yeah, how would you fix the economic crisis?
How would you fix the debt ceiling?
We're doomed. No, but I feel like if you just eradicated humans, like the world would probably thrive, like environmentally.
I would like actually 100% agree with
probably.
That.
Probably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't want it to happen.
Right.
But that
I know that it I would though.
Be, yeah, I have to
it'd be better for virtually every other species.
People yeah, are like, oh no, the world is dying. We should leave and go to Mars. I'm like, you know what? We probably should. Then the world wouldn't die. You know?
Yeah.
It's like, let's go to before it dies. Maybe the world will come bounce back. There was like some kind of limitation for a bit in Beijing. You know how the pollution is really bad there. Where like, I don't remember, it was a few years ago now, maybe several years ago, where they had a mandate where like the driving was restricted. And within 2 weeks of cutting down on the amount of people driving, like the skies cleared up and it was wow. beautiful and there was no more fog.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, so I feel like it's just humans. Like, we're the biggest threat to ourselves.